defeating issue one in Ohio, a ballot measure that would have made it much harder to amend the state's constitution to include, you know, protections for reproductive rights and abortion. And it would have also made it incredibly difficult to include ballot measures on the ballot to begin with. Well, we wouldn't be able to get to where we are today, the utter rejection of issue one, without the help of Republican voters in the state of Ohio. Now, that was the thesis of a segment I did just last week, but we didn't have all the details yet. The analysis of the demographics and how they voted had not been done yet. Well, that analysis has taken place, and I am happy to report that the situation's actually much better than I had even shared with you earlier. So about 57% of the state voted against issue one. Again, issue one was an undemocratic measure. It would have required a supermajority in order to amend the state's constitution. This was really a proxy battle for abortion rights because they want to include a ballot measure in November of 2024 that would amend the state constitution to include protection for abortion rights. It appears that about 57% of the state wants that amendment, which is why Republican lawmakers in the state pushed for issue one, which would require that supermajority of 60% in order to amend the state constitution. This is their way of, like, you know, nipping it in the bud and ensuring that there wouldn't be a state constitutional right to abortion. Now, here's the outcome. Like I said, 57% of the state voted against issue one. Ohio, as you all know, is a red state, which means there are definitely Republicans voting against issue one, which is great news, common ground. Well, here are the details. Biden counties around cities voted against changing the rules to amend the state constitution, but they were joined by suburban counties in the state that went for Trump. In total, 22 Ohio counties voted against amending the state constitution. All of them are around larger cities and college towns, and most of them are suburban and exurban counties that voted for Trump in 2020. There also seems to be a difference between MAGA Republicans and non-MAGA Republicans in the state and how they, not necessarily how they voted. I think that there is a distinction between how they voted on issue one and how they respond to pollsters. So for instance, among MAGA supporters, 80% of them, according to these polls, say that they approve of overturning Roe. But among non-MAGA voters, only 51% say they approve in a poll that reported a margin of sampling error of plus or minus 4.38 percentage points. Okay, so this is to say that they might respond one way to the polling, but once push comes to shove and the impact of banning abortion is real for them, all of a sudden they vote a little differently, right? And that was definitely something that played out with issue one in Ohio. Now, Ohio isn't alone in this pattern of having, like, basically Republican voters support ballot initiatives that Democratic voters want. So I want to give you a few other examples. So apparently last year, six states had abortion measures on the ballot, three that aimed to codify or expand abortion rights, and three were designed to restrict them. And in each case, the side that favored abortion rights won out. So Kansas, there was the vote on an amendment to essentially remove abortion as a right from the state constitution. We all remember how that played out, right? Kansas, not a blue state. Kansas, very much a red state. So how did this all play out? Well, in 2020, Biden won only five counties around Kansas City, Topeka, and Lawrence, and Manhattan. And the state's two big college towns, okay? Or the state's two big college towns. Now in total, 90 counties voted no last year, meaning that the counties who overwhelmingly supported Donald Trump over Biden voted to protect abortion rights in their state. So do we accept the common ground here, or do we just reject it? Right? Like, this is the point that I'm trying to make. When there are areas of common ground, take the win. And try to understand that, yes, there are gonna be areas of disagreement for sure, but where we can work together to win, we should work together to win. And that's exactly what's happening in some of these states. There was also Michigan. There was a referendum last year that made abortion a right in the state constitution. In 2020, Biden won 11 counties in Michigan. Last year, the proposal to codify abortion rights won in all those counties, as well as in suburban counties around Detroit, Kalamazoo, and Lansing. All told, 26 counties voted for the measure. There are areas of common ground. We need to take those wins where we can get it. And I'm really happy to see what the outcome of issue one was in Ohio. Super happy to see that these ballot initiatives are continuing to surprise us with results that, you know, if you just base your worldview on how legacy media reports on these issues, you would believe that like there's no way that these kinds of ballot measures are gonna work in states that are considered red states. But these shockers keep coming one after another, and I hope they continue to. Just trying to get you guys to see the other perspective, the areas of common ground, when there's just this endless media deluge of you know, reports about how divided and polarized we are, how much we all hate each other. Not necessarily the case when it comes to some of these issues.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.